President Marcos and several senators facing backlash online over Senator Sonny Angara's birthday bash over the weekend. In a viral video posted by Cavite lawmaker Lani Mercado Revilla and also by Senate President Miguel Zubiri, Marcos was seen partying and singing along with other senators on stage. One Twitter user noted how the officials were enjoying their money and power, while many Filipinos are currently suffering from poverty and hunger. Former Senate President Vicente Soto III refusing to comment on his past colleagues' merrymaking.
Well, it was the birthday of Senator Sonny Angara, so I refused to comment. I was invited. Mm-hmm. I was invited, but I sent already a video.
In his defense, Senator Angara said on his Instagram, the festivity wasn't just to celebrate his birthday, but was also for a good cause. Angara said he asked his guests to donate to the Philippine General Hospital in lieu of gifts. He adds they were able to raise 3 million pesos that night. Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia gives his guarantee. The Filipino people will be able to restore its trust to the poll body under his watch. Garcia says this can be done through institutionalizing transparency.
From the first phase to the last phase of proclaiming the winner, we will have to ensure that the public will always be informed, that all stakeholders will have not only being able to observe, but will have complete participation for purposes of at least ensuring a credible and honest election. Transparency is the key and accountability is likewise the key. We have to ensure that. Otherwise, regardless of all the efforts that the COMELEC will give to ensure an honest and credible election, if the people does not believe not only on our credibility, not only on the system that we are putting in place, then we will not be able to get that support from the commission, from the people, and from the entire nation in general.
Some business headlines now. The Philippine unemployment rate remains at 6% in June. This translates to 2.99 million unemployed Filipinos. While the unemployment rate was unchanged from May, it's an uptick from the 2.93 million unemployed individuals during that period. As for the underemployment rate, it went down to 12.6% in June from 14.5% in May. On a month-to-month basis, agriculture and forestry, public administration and defense, as well as the education sector, added the most jobs in June. On the flip side, wholesale and retail trade, manufacturing and accommodation service activities shed the most jobs. The Philippine economy grew at a slightly slower pace in the first quarter of the year. The Philippine Statistics Authority revised the country's first quarter GDP expansion to 8.2%. down from the previously reported growth of 8.3%. The downward revision was due to adjustments in the real estate ownership of dwellings and manufacturing. This comes ahead of the release of Manila's second quarter growth figures on Tuesday. President Marcos reminds the Philippine Police Force, the use of force must always be reasonable and justifiable. Speaking at the 121st Police Service Anniversary Celebration at Camp Crame, Marcos said the authority of the police should also be grounded on moral principles and accountability.
Execution of authority must be fair. It must be impartial. It must be devoid of favoritism and or discrimination, regardless of race, gender, socioeconomic status, political affiliation, religious belief, and the like. It is only then that you can effectively sustain with great respect and wide support the authority that you possess as uniformed servicemen of the Republic.
After gracing the PNP's event this morning, Marcos is attending the change of command ceremony of the Armed Forces of the Philippines at Camp Aguinaldo in Quezon City. We're showing you live shots of that event now. Medal of Valor awardee Lieutenant General Bartolome Vicente Bacaro will become the next AFP chief, replacing General Andres Centino. The new head of the military will be the first AFP chief of staff who will serve under a fixed term of 3 years. This means Bacaro will serve until 2025, even if he reaches the mandatory retirement age of 56 this year.